Murray's birthday today, and it's a great day. The ownership of the Blues, of course, back in New York. And JD, first of all, congratulations on a great ceremony.
Thank you, guys.
It was very enjoyable.
Yeah. You know what's interesting here, looking at Pat DiPuzzo there and our players going over and shaking hands. There's one little guy in behind Pat there. He's got a Billy Guerin jersey on. I saw him before the game. He gave me a dirty look. Because he knows we traded Billy to San Jose. Pat DiPuzzo's from Hoboken, New Jersey. It's an amazing thing. A kid that grew up there, and he's now been part of 1,500 games in the National Hockey League. That linesman cares about the NHL. He works hard, and congratulations to him. As far as Bernie and John, as far as our day went here, I was here a long time in New York after the Blues traded me back in the early 70s. It was a great place for us. We have a lot of great memories. They were very kind to do what they did. It was special for us, for my wife and my daughters and everybody. And it was some crazy days, some good old days. And
John, going to the finals in 79, would you think as a player was your highlight?
It was. We beat the Islanders in the semis, and that captivated the city. That's Glenn Sather beside me there when we was with the Blues, and we were up in Banff, Alberta on horses. But yeah, it was a fantastic time and a great experience.
Look out, 2-on-1. Oh, Yager missed everything on a 2-on-1. That's the last guy you want shooting on a 2-on-1, but he missed the entire net.
He doesn't miss the net very often, Gang.
Wow.
I don't really think anybody knows this Ranger team better than you do, JD.
Now Nylander misses a wide open goal. I mean wide open. Are my eyes going bad or what? Yager the Nylander.
Maybe the Rangers' eyes are going bad. And here's an icing. Boy, we got flat here. That was a great shift by the Rangers. And I don't know if there's some intervention somewhere or something going on here. But
how did Nylander miss that?
I thought the Yager
was 3 feet from the net.
I thought the Yager one was something.
Well, here we're going to get a look at it, too. And I don't know how this didn't go in as well. But look at this, he just got it, and he fired it all the way through the crease, which I don't think he expected this puck back. And as you reach back, I mean, that is hard to believe that you can miss from that close an angle. But John, you've seen it happen many times as a goaltender, and I know I did it a few times. When you think you've got an easy one, you lose your concentration for a second and it's not in.
Did that nick the glove of Sanford or not? Probably not, but his hand was awfully close to it. Listen, we gave up a 2-on-1 there, then a 3-on-2 down low. That's not good. You've got to be tighter, especially when it's Nylander with Yager on the ice. You've got to be much tighter.
But I think you knew that the Rangers were going to come out a lot harder to start this period.
Oh, yeah. They're trying to get into the playoffs. I mean, as are we. And we knocked the crowd out of the game in the first period, played some smart hockey. And, the Rangers' next two games are with the Islanders home and home. So maybe they're... Well, we should just take advantage of the situation is what I'm saying.
Now, John, I know you said you were a broadcaster here for over 20 years. Now, the ovation you got was absolutely unbelievable. Did you know that you were that popular when you walked out there?
The people are nice. They're good here. They have. It's like St. Louis. It's a great sports city. When you're part of the sports fabric for a long time in one place, the people, they recognize it. They're smart. They understand. And I see it in St. Louis, in the history in St. Louis. I see it with what's going on with ball players and hockey players. I see what they do when you're around Bernie and the fans, and I saw what they did for Brad Hull and even Billy Guerin, who wasn't there very long, what they did for him. Sports fans are great, and here in New York, I was lucky to be part of the sports fabric for, I guess, 3 decades here. And this arena is, as you know, John, you worked here too. It's some joint, isn't it?
It's electric, especially when things are going well. When things go back,
don't let
them
know that too, right?
Well, it's got to be so rewarding for you. I mean, we had headsets off during that ceremony. I mean, they were chanting JD, yeah. JD. That's got to make you feel so darn good.
Yeah, it did. It was nice for the family, for everybody. And now that that's out of the way, we can sort of go forward. Our club started well here and try to get 2 points and keep moving up in the standings.
2 minutes gone here, second period. Blues leading by a couple. First period goals. First from Boys and then Dvorak. The Rangers try to get something going here. And the Blues clog up the blue line, but now flipped in by Orr. John, I heard a couple of interviews that you did over the last few days, and I know you've been a popular guy since you've come back, but not once have I heard you say you've regretted your decision at all to change positions and come to St. Louis.
Not at all, John. St. Louis has welcomed myself and our family. This is a career opportunity. An offside here, career opportunity to try and be part of a revival with the Blues, and everybody's worked hard. Everybody from from the sales staff to the players to the trainers to the coaches to the broadcasting outfits to you guys, we're all trying to revive the St. Louis Blues in the city of St. Louis, and there's one of the main people, Andy Murray, and what he's done for us. We've come a long way since July 1st. We got a long way to go, but you feel it. You know, you feel something good going on, and I think it's almost like it's osmosis. People can feel it. They sense that we're doing some good stuff. We're reconnecting in the community. We're going to rinks. We're doing all kinds of different things, and people appreciate that. We're back working hard the way we promised we would. Good things are going on.
Now, in your 30-plus years of hockey, has this been your most, leading up to the week before the trade deadline, is this the most strenuous week you've ever had in your life?
I think as a player, you